Hi all, Dan here, one of the instructors that works at both Buckton and Ingleborough here. Hope everyone's well. While we're out, I'll say the instructors have been tasked with making some videos with regards to some of the stuff we might go through educational-wise while we're at centres, when we're taking out groups doing activities. Today I've come for a bike ride, currently on my way up Pendle Hill, somewhere up there behind me. And we've come across, just down here, this nice little stream. And it's quite often something that's reflected through a lot of the activities we do, whether it's we're going gorge scrambling, whether we're going caving, there's always an element of the environment that's come naturally, and hence talking about the erosion that's been caused by the water cycle. A common question that we'll ask, where's the water come from? Why is it coming down here and creating this erosion? And get into the point of the water cycle. Nice hot sunny day like today, there's not many clouds up in the sky. Well, the next step from that is those clouds get more and more water inside them. Where does that come from? Well, it comes from the ocean, from the ground. As it heats up from the sunlight, that causes evaporation of that water, and it rises into the sky and then condenses to form some of those little clouds up there behind me. As those clouds get more and more water particles in them, they start to get darker and heavier. Eventually, they'll let go of that water in the form of droplets and precipitation. It falls back to the ground as rain. Generally, that water is going to fall slightly more concentrated over higher grounds, over hills, mountains, places like that. And then the other thing that many people learn about very easily is gravity. It's keeping you on this planet. But it's also a big part of that water cycle, as it pulls the water down to find the easiest way back into a river and back down towards the ocean. Sometimes it might deviate, it might go underground through a cave system, an underground river, and at that point it could potentially take a lot longer to get back to the ocean, but it's still going in that consistent cycle. The water will make its way back to the ocean, get evaporated, condense, form clouds, come back down to the ground as rain, into the rivers, creating that little bit of erosion that we've got here, which can become much bigger, create caves, create the gorges, those places that we can't wait to get back to take groups out in again.